But it is obvious just the world economy is in expansionary process. If you look at stock prices, or employment number, or growth rate, or even just rising long-term interest rate, it all shows just world economy is expanding. But probably this is not the place where you're just speaking only optimistic picture. So let me just raise three maybe concerns or problems. Some have already said by other people. One is just very low growth rate. Not just growth rate, very low potential growth rate. So this may be very much related to what people call the secular stagnation. And behind is the very low productivity. I don't know how technology is related. It may be too early to speaking about just influence of AI or IoT to the productivity, because if you look at the previous innovation, there's some long time lag between the introduction of technology and growth. But I think maybe I agree to you that there's some substantial structural problem in the economy, which just makes the growth rate is very low. So in Japan, we have a lot of discussion about just the increasing importance of reform to just accelerate the reallocation of resources, especially reforming labor market is very important. Without just reallocation of labor, it is very difficult to just raise the growth rate. And also, in the case of Japan, and perhaps maybe many other countries, just investment of human resources is very weak in the past. And so that may just provide another reason why productivity grows. And trade is very important. There are many discussions about the increasing protectionism, and yes, that is a concern. But at the same time, still we can have some perspective about this, the increasing the free trade regime. In the case of Japan, for example, the economic partnership with Europe, I hope will be concluded by the end of this year. And also even TPP, although United States is out, but we still try to just finish the TPP 11, I mean, excluding United States, by the end of this year. But this kind of, I think, just you know, stepping forward is very important in order to just get more profit by surprise the allocation. Now, second concern, which is also talked by some other people, very low inflation rate and wage rate. And usually, low inflation rate is very good. But we have to remember, just major countries just implemented very, very expansion in monetary policy and very stimulative economic policy and very low interest rate. But still, the inflation rate and wage rate is very low, especially in the case of Japan. If you look at the Japanese case, as you know, we just introduced very expansionary monetary policy, and unemployment rate is the lowest in the last 20 years, and stock price is the highest in the last 20 years. Still, inflation rate is just around 0.5%. And wage is increasing very slowly, and so because nominal GDP is increasing, that means very dramatic drop of the wage share in GDP. So there must be some kind of structural problem here again. I don't know, technology, maybe measurement, but we have to think more seriously about this low inflation rate. And third, I think Kemal just mentioned the importance of the risk of debt, and I agree. But I want to just emphasize the other side, risk of the asset. You have to look at just the price of the stocks and real estate. Because of the maybe low, very, very low interest rate, in most countries, probably the stock price and the real estate prices are among the highest in the past. And it's very difficult to say whether this is a bubble or not because of the low interest rate. But however, in the process of the increasing interest rate from now on, I hope, it is very possible that there's some drop of the asset price after the interest adjustment. And increasing interest rate is very important process for normalization of the global economy. However, increasing interest rate is very difficult process if we just expect some kind of reaction of the asset price. So we have to watch very carefully about the response to the asset price to the interest rate. Thank you.